Hello friends, Pastor Emmanuel Ogbechie here of Diplomats Assembly. I want to welcome you to Homologio, Faith Confessions that Shape Our Lives. Today we're going to be confessing the Word of God again, and it's so amazing how the results of confessing the Word of God, you know, are littered all through the Scriptures. We can see the evidence of what God's Word can do when men put them in their mouth. Before we go again to declare the Word of God today, I want to read to you from Deuteronomy chapter number 11. I want you to turn in your Bibles there to Deuteronomy chapter number 11. Amazing scripture, powerful, powerful scripture, you know, that gives us a very important insight into the power of confessions. Deuteronomy chapter 11, we read from verse number 18. Deuteronomy 11 and verse number 18. Hallelujah. The Bible says, "Therefore shall ye lay up these my words in your heart." God is speaking to us. He said, "You shall lay up these my words." So we're going to go back and look at the words which we are expected to lay up in our hearts. He said, "You shall lay up these my words in your heart and in your soul, and bind them for a sign upon your hand, that they may be as frontlets between your eyes." Hallelujah. "And you shall teach them your children, speaking of them." Emphasis. Speaking of them, speaking of them. I want you to note that part. Speaking of them. So God expects us to lay up his words in our heart and speak them, confess them, proclaim them, declare them. You shall teach your children, verse 19, speaking of them when thou sittest in thine house and when thou walkest by the way. So God is saying, I want you confessing my word all the time. Everywhere you are, everywhere you go, on the road, in the car, in your house, wherever you find yourself, confessing my words. Notice why he's asking us to confess his words, the power of confessions. He says, "You should teach them your children and speak of them when thou sittest in the house and when thou walkest by the way, when thou liest down and when thou risest up." In other words, every single day, every single period of your life, and where you're lying down, where you're getting up, what should be coming out of your mouth is the word of God, the confession of the word of God should be coming out of your mouth. He says in verse 20, "And thou shalt write them upon the doorposts of the house and upon thy gates." Verse 21 then goes ahead to tell the reason why we must confess God's word. He said, "So that your days may be multiplied and the days of your children." So that your days may be multiplied and the days of your children. In the land which the Lord swore unto your fathers to give them, as the days of heaven upon the earth." Amazing. So God is saying, I expect your life on earth to be graced, blessed, prosperous, as though you were already in heaven. But in order for you to enjoy a life of heaven on earth, you will need to take my words of promises, put them in your mouth, confess them, declare them, speak about them every time. Notice it's not something you do once in a while. It's not something you do, you know, only at the beginning of the year or on the 31st night. No, it is something you should do every day, when you're lying down, when you're sitting up, when you are, you know, wherever, every aspect of your life, every time. He says you should be declaring the words of God. Hallelujah. And this is one of the reasons why we are taking the word of God and we're proclaiming them. And today we want to proclaim God's word from this same scripture where he says we should take these words and lay it up in our hearts. So we'll go to verse 8 of this scripture, Deuteronomy 11 and verse number 8. So we're going to begin our confessions from this scripture. It says, Deuteronomy 11 verse 8, "Say, therefore shall ye keep all the commandments that I command you this day, that ye may be strong and go in and possess the land whither ye go to possess it. And so we are going to boldly declare, we're going to say, we thank you, Father, because we keep your commandments in the name of Jesus. We have grace to keep his commandments. Make that declaration. I have grace to keep his commandments. And in the name of Jesus, I keep his commandments. In Jesus' name. Can you declare that after me? Say, I keep God's commandments through the grace of our Lord Jesus. And therefore, I boldly declare that I am strong. Can you say that? Say, I am strong in the name of Jesus. And I go in. Hallelujah. Say that loud. Say, I go in and I possess the land. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, I possess the land whithersoever I go to possess it. Say this loudly after me. Say, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, I succeed in every vocation which I have found myself involved in. Say it one more time. I succeed in every vocation which I have found myself involved in the name of Jesus. Whatsoever my hand has set out to pursue, I succeed at it in the name of Jesus. In the light of this scripture, I possess the land whithersoever I go to possess it. In other words, everything you set out to accomplish, you accomplish it. Say that. Say, everything I set out to accomplish, I accomplish it in the name of Jesus. Verse 9 says, and that ye may prolong your days in the land. Say this as loud as you can after me. Say, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, my days are multiplied. My days are multiplied in the land which the Lord my God has given me. In the land which the Lord my God has given me, as the days of heaven upon the earth. Say that. As the days of heaven upon the earth. I live on earth as though I am already in heaven. I live on earth as though I am already in heaven. In the name of Jesus Christ, I boldly declare that I inherit a land. Say that. I inherit a land that flows with milk and honey. That flows with milk and honey. I drink of the milk and the honey of the land where I dwell. Say that loudly. I drink of the milk and of the honey of the land where I dwell. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Verse number 10 says, for the land whither thou goest in to possess it is not as the land of Egypt, from whence ye came out, where thou sowest the seed with you and waterest it with thy foot as a garden of herbs. But the land whither ye go to possess it is a land of hills and valleys, and drinketh water of the rain of heaven. Can you say this after me? Say, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I have come out of the Egyptian life. I have come out of the Egyptian life. And I am free from the Egyptian experiences. I am free from Egyptian experiences. I am free from the hardship of the unregenerated man. I am free from the hardship of the unregenerated man. In the name of Jesus, I receive rain upon my land. I receive rain from heaven upon my land. The rain of the Holy Spirit, say this loud, the rain of the Holy Spirit falls upon me daily. Falls upon me daily in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. And the rain of the Holy Spirit is making me fruitful. Say that. The rain of the Holy Spirit is making me fruitful in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Say, my land drinks rain from heaven above. Say that. My land drinks rain from heaven above. Say, in the name of Jesus, the works of my hands enjoy the rain of favor from heaven. Can you make that declaration? Say the works of my hands enjoy the rain of favor from heaven in the name of Jesus. I and my household will live a life free from struggling. I and my household will live a land free from struggling in the name of Jesus. Verse 12 says, a land which the Lord our God cared for, the eyes of the Lord are always upon it from the beginning of the year, even upon the end of the year. Say in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, the eyes of the Lord are upon my life. The eyes of the Lord are upon my life. Say it is written, it is written. The eyes of the Lord are over the righteous. The eyes of the Lord are over the righteous. And I am the righteous. Say that, I am the righteous. Therefore, the eyes of the Lord are upon me today. The eyes of the Lord are upon me today. From the beginning of the year unto the end. From the beginning of the year unto the end, the light of God's grace prospers me on all fronts. Say that, the light of God's grace prospers me on all fronts. Make this bold declaration. Say the year is crowned for me with God's goodness. The year is crowned for me with God's goodness in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Make this bold declaration. Say, I hearken diligently unto the commandments of the Lord my God. Unto the commandments of the Lord my God. Say this loud. Say, my spirit is obedient to the voice of the Holy Spirit. To the voice of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Make this bold declaration. Say, I do not resist the voice of the Holy Spirit. I do not resist the voice of the Holy Spirit. But I'm yielded to the Spirit. Make this confession. Say, I am yielded to the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus. I love the Lord my God. Make that confession. Say, I love the Lord my God in the name of Jesus. And I serve him with all my heart. Declare that. I serve him with all my heart in the name of Jesus. And with all my soul, I serve the Lord. And with all my soul, I serve the Lord. And therefore, I receive. Make this declaration. I receive, therefore I receive the force, the rain upon my land, the rain upon my land in his season, the first rain and the latter rain, the first rain and the latter rain is upon my land, is upon my land, is upon my family, is upon my family. The rain of the Holy Spirit, the rain of the Holy Spirit is upon my land in the name of Jesus. Therefore, say this loud, therefore, I gather in my corn, I gather in my wine, I gather in my oil. Say that, I gather in corn, I gather in wine, I gather in oil in the name of Jesus. I receive grass upon my fields of endeavors in the name of Jesus. Everything my hands is set apart to do prospers through the influence of grace in the name of Jesus. I receive grass upon my fields for my cattle in the name of Jesus. They eat and they are full in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And I live free from idolatry. Say that, I live free from idolatry in the name of Jesus Christ. I am free from idolatry. Make this bold declaration. See, I remember the Lord my God, the Lord my God, for it is he that gives me power to get wealth. For it is he that gives me power to get wealth. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you. I thank you because you have made me victorious. You have made me victorious. I live a life of heaven on earth today. I live a life of heaven on earth today. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amazing, powerful, 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 powerful opportunity we have to declare God's words. Amen. I believe God's words is changing our life. And I want you to, you know, keep these confessions going. Listen to them again and again and again. Get the audios, get the videos. Listen to them again and declare them, confess them, and your life will never be the same again. Now, Pastor Emmanuel Ogbechie here saying, have a great day. God bless you richly and bye-bye.